In this video, I'm going to explore prototyping this water wheel exhibit for the American Precision Museum in Vermont, here in the United States. As modern 3D printing has become more cost-effective and commonplace, it is often a good idea to prototype an assembly before going right to a CNC for full-scale manufacturing. This can help find and fix any design flaws or issues before making those costly mistakes with expensive material and tooling or wasting valuable machine time. In this case, we'll be looking at new tools available in Mastercam 2022 that can assist with just that. The best part of this is that these tools are available for free in the all-new Mastercam Demo Home Learning Edition, whether you are a Mastercam customer or not. A free Home Learning Edition of Mastercam can be requested by going to www.mastercam.com/solutions/homelearningedition. Let's get started. The original exhibit is made from 3/4-inch plywood. It's almost 48 inches across, or 1200 millimeters. Since most consumer-grade 3D printers are around a 200 by 200 millimeter table size, printing a full-size model for this design verification would not be feasible. Instead, let's scale the assembly down. Window select all the entities. The contextual tool tab will come up on the ribbon, and I'll select Scale. Use Move instead of Copy. I'll scale this model down to 10% its original size. This will allow even the largest pieces to fit on the printer table, while also allowing enough definition in smaller features like the rabbits and dados to check proper fitment and assembly. For the real exhibit, the joinery will be connected by screws, but for this smaller prototype, I'm planning on gluing the joints together. Once Mastercam has scaled down the assembly, I'll use clear colors on the Home tab to clean up the graphics view. For this prototype, I'm most concerned with the plywood components and not interested in 3D printing the hardware portions of this assembly. I'll go into the Levels Manager and shut off the level that contains all the hardware. The assembly components are now at a scale that we can print, but there is still more to do. A 3D printer typically works off mesh models, so these models in their current solid form are not usable. I could save these off directly as a mesh file type, but instead, let's create the mesh inside of Mastercam and take a look at some new tools. Historically, you would not have wanted to do this as mesh entities were notoriously tough to deal with inside of Mastercam. That is no longer the case, as Mastercam 2022 now offers full support of mesh entities. This enhancement includes a large array of new tools. Notice the new mesh tab at the top of the ribbon, and the plethora of new mesh manipulation tools found there. I'll launch the new Mesh From Entities function. This creates a mesh from all solid or surface entities. Select the arrow to add entities and window select the entire assembly. In the interest of keeping this file as neat as possible, I'll delete the original solid models. The calculated mesh tolerance can be specified, but the default should be more than accurate for what my printer can deliver anyway. Click OK, and Mastercam will convert all the entities to meshes. Mastercam's full support for mesh entities includes the ability to change mesh colors. I'll change the entire assembly over to gray, and I can even differentiate the wheel components if desired. Since I'm most concerned with how these components will go together on the real exhibit, I will need to print each separately to get a feel for the real assembly process. To do that, I could isolate each component and move it around with Dynamic Transform. Instead, let's leverage the new mesh capabilities in Model Prep and use Disassemble. Launch the function and window select the entire structure. I'll select Copy so that I have the complete assembly to reference and leave a 25 millimeter spacing between the components. By default, Mastercam will line up the components along the X positive axis starting at zero. The default should work well for what we are trying to do here. Typically, when disassembling, sort by thickness proves to be a useful function, but these components are made from the same thickness plywood, so there isn't much benefit for this task. I'm going to copy these components to a new level, incremented by 1,000 each. Click OK. Zoom out and notice that it has laid out every single component as desired. Each component is separate and ready for printing. If nesting was desired, Mastercam's automated nesting functionality now also supports meshes. Instead, I'm going to take a couple of components and manually position them for testing. Since this is the first print at this thickness and material, I'd like to see how things go before committing to a full nest. From experience, I'm concerned with how the rabbits and dados will mate with other components. The finished flatness of the larger wheel sections is also a risk. Notice that by simply clicking on this mesh entity, a tool contextual tab pops up in the ribbon, just like it would for any other type of entity, but now it's populated with functions that would be useful with the mesh entity. Click the dynamic transform and move the wheel component to set up this first print. Once in position, click OK. In the past, doing all this work in the free demo HLE version of Mastercam would just be for self-education or fun. There was no way to get useful data out of the software to a machine since post-processing is restricted. This brings us to yet another big change for Mastercam 2022. In past years, the demo HLE version of Mastercam only supported saving EMCAM file types, which can only be opened in Mastercam with an educational license. With Mastercam 2022 demo HLE, I can easily save out STL and 3MF file types, which are compatible with most slicing software and 3D printers. With the new mesh support and a collection of useful mesh tools, the free version of Mastercam is now more useful than ever before. Okay, let's save these off and get them ready to print. Go to File, Save Some, and pick the two desired meshes. I'm going to use an STL file type and save this off to my desktop, where it is ready to be loaded into my favorite slicing software. Hopefully after watching this demo, you are now aware of the integration and full mesh support in Mastercam 2022. Demo HLE also has increased functionality and usefulness for 3D printing, even in a commercial application. Whether you are looking to improve your skills at home, a 3D printing hobbyist, a student, or just curious about what Mastercam has to offer, head over to our website and request a copy of the new and improved Demo HLE.